Hey guys, Sprague here. Welcome back to the Daily Craft, the show where I do some crafting on one of my characters and we talk about everything WoW gold making and WoW in general. Today I am back on my Enchanter Jewel Crafter, my main character, my favourite character to craft on because it's so much easier than the others. Very quick to do and it is costing us 458 and a 427 profit. So again, like 100% profit, really, really nice. Now I do have to apologise, I have not done a video in a week, around 1 week's time. I was skiing in France, went on a bit of a holiday with some old uni friends, so that was really, really fun. And yeah, I didn't go on WoW the entire week. Now for me, that's pretty crazy. I can't remember the last time I didn't go on WoW once for an entire week. I usually just go on to check my auctions at least, but I didn't even do that because I was a bit too busy. But I did have a great time. And I don't know, I think sometimes having a little break from the game can really reinvigorate your interest and your passion for it. And whilst I certainly wasn't disinterested in the game, because of this time in the expansion, it's always a bit harder to get yourself motivated because there's nothing new out. And having a small break of a few days can often help you sort of sort yourself out and really get back into things, really want to try and improve whatever you're doing in the game. For me, that is mostly gold making, so I really want to up my gold making game, get ready for Battle for Azeroth. I'm actually pretty hyped, so things are looking good. Speaking of Battle for Azeroth, I am still not in the beta, alpha, whatever you're calling it, which is unfortunate. I don't think they even give out keys, so it's not like I can ask one of you guys if you've got a spare key or something. They don't really do that anymore. I think they mostly just accept your Battle.net and put your Battle.net launcher into the alpha and then you can install it from there, so that's unfortunate. Hopefully I'll get in soon. I know there are more and more invites going out to smaller YouTubers and that, so hopefully I will get a chance at some point. But from what I've been hearing, there have been quite a few sort of bugs, quite a few things that aren't working, especially on the profession gold making side, so I don't think we're missing out on too much just yet. But yeah, one thing I really wanted to ask in this video is, what are your guys' sort of main plans for Battle for Azeroth? Do you have any goals you want to reach before the expansion or during the expansion? And I don't know, what are you kind of thinking about doing? For me, it's simple. It's about doing things that I've already been doing this expansion, but doing them a lot more efficiently, a lot better, and making a lot more gold from them. For example, this expansion, I doubled the number of realms that I'm selling pets on, and I doubled or even tripled the number of realms that I flip BOEs and other items on. And I really want to continue in that vein. I also started multi-boxing this expansion. I started leveling a crazy number of alts to do professions with. And all that stuff is just things that I want to continue on in Battle for Azeroth. But I want to be doing it a lot better, a lot more successfully, hopefully. Particularly the multi-boxing. Right now, my multi-boxing accounts are deactivated because I just wasn't having the time really to use them. I wasn't farming properly on them. But as we all know, the start of an expansion is the best possible time to do a bit of farming. So even if you dislike farming like myself, potentially multi-boxing will be worth it for that short amount of time. You know, I'm even thinking about leveling my multi-boxes first. I always level this character, Bregolad, always level him first because, I don't know, it's just my main character. But I'm thinking it may be better to level my multi-boxes all at once first. Give me a chance to gather things straight away and get some crazy gold per hour with that. It would also give me a chance to cover all the professions right when the expansion launches, because if you can cover all the professions, then you're going to be making gold from everything and not missing out on any crazy things, such as what happened at the start of Legion, where the whole Obliterum Forge and the braces needed for them was making crazy gold. You know, my server, you were getting 10,000 gold profit every time you sold a braces, and you could sell 20 braces a day easily. You know, I made over 1 million gold in a few days just from selling these braces and other things. So it was a bit crazy, and there's always something similar to that at the start of expansions if you can be quick enough and get there and try and see what you can do. So that's what I'll be doing. Now, there's been a lot of talk recently about the new Blood of Sargeras that's being introduced into Battle for Azeroth. So there's another item similar to Blood of Sargeras. It's going to work the same sort of way. So you're going to need some of it for some crafting professions, for a lot of the crafts, and it's not super easy to get. Similar to Blood of Sargeras, it's also BOP, and you know, it's going to work in a very similar way. However, certain people have been saying, and I know Gumdrops has talked a lot about this, the fact that potentially you can get this new Blood of Sargeras from other means, potentially from sort of disenchanting or the new sort of disenchanting forge thing that's coming in Battle for Azeroth. So this item's called the Scrapper, and basically it seems to be a sort of obliterant forge where you put some items into it and you get some of the items that you can use to craft that out of it. And you can also get some Expulsum, which is the new Blood of Sargeras. You can also get that out of it. What this basically could mean is any character who doesn't go out in the world to do dailies, run missions, do all the gathering, all the things that can get you Blood of Sargeras, you can have an ult which doesn't do that, but if you can use the Scrapper to your advantage, you can still get enough Blood of Sargeras. Now for me, and someone who has many, many ults and does a lot of crafting, this is amazing, because what it could mean is that you don't have to go and do all the daily quests on so many characters and then run out of Blood of Sargeras, so you can't go and do all of the crafting you want. This could give us a way of sort of managing that a bit better. If you have a lot of gold, you can invest in items, you can then scrap them, you can then get the new Blood of Sargeras on one of your alts, and you can use that to start crafting things. So it's quite good, because it still doesn't mean it's crazily available like a non-bop item, but it still means it's a bit more accessible for those of us who maybe don't want to do so many dailies or so many gathering things on all of our alts. But yeah, I really am excited about what's going to happen in Battle for Azeroth. The expansion itself actually looks really cool as well. I mean, we still don't have too much information. There's a lot of the main systems that haven't even been introduced, and apart from we keep hearing about the new allied races that are going to be coming, in terms of the actual gameplay, we really don't know a whole lot. So it's not like it's super soon. It's obviously still a fair few months away, but I can still be very excited about it. Now, in terms of my plans for before the expansion launches, I am of course going to be moving server. For those of you who didn't know, I'm moving to a Horde server, a very similar server to this one, but has a lot more raiding guilds, so my guild want to move there, which is good, and the economy still looks very good. It's my sort of economy, the sort of high pop server, but not the very, very highest pop, so, you know, still got a bit of room without so much competition, which is the server that I like, so I'm very excited about that. I'm also excited about the whole transfer. Now, as you guys may have known from my Gold Cap Challenge series, I love to transfer guild banks full of items to transfer my gold, and I don't know, that way it just lets you make gold from the transfer, because otherwise it's a bit boring transferring, but if you can actually make gold from a transfer, then it's really cool. So I'll do a whole video or video series on that, which I think would be useful for some people. See how much gold I can make. A fair few million, I hope. That's going to be good. And yeah, got to get started on the new server. I mean, I might do a whole new Gold Cap Challenge series on the new server. What I was thinking of doing is something like that when the expansion launches. So see how long it can take me to make however many million gold the second the expansion launches. Should be pretty quick, because it's pretty crazy, that start of the expansion gold rush. So that should be cool. I'm excited about that. And obviously doing all the new profession guides and all the new gold guides for the new expansion. Those always go down well. And hopefully some other sort of guides as well, not just gold. I mean, my channel has primarily been about gold, but I do like talking about other stuff as well. A lot of people don't like me talking about other stuff. Think I'm just about gold, but a lot of people do like my opinion on certain other things, and I like sharing it, so we'll probably do a bit of those guides as well, but of course mostly concentrating on the gold. Anyways, we're just about done, just been crafting the last few items, a few of the Pandemonite chokers, which always sell really, really good, over 100k on my server, and people always say, how does it sell for that much? And I agree, it's stupid, but the price does stay the same, and I do sell them at that price, as I've shown on my my recent sales video series. So I do get sales like that. I don't know why, but I do. So I continue to craft when I sell. As always, I only craft the items that I've recently sold. So for example, the Imperial Crowns, I've sold a few of those recently, so I'm crafting more of them. That's just how it works. And do we get any good procs? Decimator, pretty good. And Fire Flash, again, pretty good. Not too bad, indeed. Another interesting thing recently was that the Saber's Eyes have been reset on my server, and all of the Saber's Eyes are making well over 1,500 gold profit each. some up to 2,000 gold, as you can see. So a bit strange, not usually that much, but I'm going to count that the reset is going to hold price at least for a day or two so I can sell all of my gems. It is reset day tomorrow, so the demand will still be pretty high, and I'm thinking the price will at least hold till then. So run a few cancel scans and I'll sell the rest of these and make what, around 1.7k profit times 30. So pretty nice profit, probably 50k or so. So really not too bad at all, considering these are so easy to make. And yeah, I'm glad Blizzard didn't kill off the market for these. I mean, they killed off the market for the 150 stats gems, like the 150 crit, 150 mastery, because they made the 200 crit, 200 mastery, and who's going to win the 150 when you can just buy the 200? So they kind of killed that market, which was a shame, but they still haven't killed the intellect, strength, whatever market, which is good. I mean, I know a lot of people just don't use these anyway, because for a lot of people, mastery, crit, haste is actually better than the main stat. So that's kind of interesting. And now for the Tome of Illusions. As always, they have been selling really good. Elemental Lords been selling for well over 6k. This is always the one that sells for the most on my server. I mean, I don't know if it's because you have to do something slightly more difficult to get it. I mean, not difficult, but you have to have a certain reputation, I believe, with a faction, and so not every enchanter has the Elemental Lords. Same with the Shadow Pan. So maybe that's why those make more profit than the others. I really don't know. And of course, the Old World enchants, like I always say, always put a few of these up because they always sell. I'm always making four of them because they all sell, so it tells me to craft all of the rest of them again. Over 2k profit for all of these, or over 1k profit for all of them. Over 2k for the Dancing Steel. It's kind of crazy, to be honest. I am kind of excited about enchants in the new expansion because of the fact that weapons are coming back. And the whole weapon enchant thing is also coming back, I believe. As well as some new enchants for making your Hearthstone shorter, I think. I think they're kind of trying to mix up the enchanting, make it a bit more fun, instead of just all about increasing stats like it has been in the past. So that should be interesting. I hope they do that. I wouldn't say enchanting needs it, because it's already such a good profession. It probably doesn't need so much work as some of the others do. But if it gets some love, I'll always be happy, because I love enchanting. I'm actually going to be keeping enchanting on my main for the new expansion, and I'll also be having engineering on my main. Now, the reason I got rid of engineering because it wasn't that good in this expansion, and jewel crafting was really good to have because of the Blood of Sargeras. But as I talked about earlier in the video, it seems the new Blood of Sargeras will be a bit easier to get, and it might not be such an issue to have blood intensive professions on your main. I really hope that's the case, because it means we can do fun stuff. I can get engineering back on my main. I really like it, because then I can use all the toys more often. I can go super big in the raids and get on my Spectral Tiger and show off to everyone. You know, all the stuff that's important in life. So I hope that they do that. Even if they don't, I'm still going to be going back to engineering, because it's just fun. It's just fun to have on a main, and I'm going to miss... I've just really missed it, this expansion. Anyway, that is it for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, see ya.